Hi, welcome to another episode in the series How to Make Your Own Game in Unity. I hope now you have a basic understanding of how Unity environment work. If not, I will link previous video above. Today we will start with a bit of programming in Unity. Before we start, please don't forget to subscribe and click on the bell icon so you never miss a video again. Now, C++ have always been my favorite programming languages. How its compiler compiles all the simple sense-making sentences to machine language and easily run our code and understands our command has always intrigued me. When C# was introduced, I was so excited to work with the amazing environment of Visual Studio. But Unity took that to a whole new level. With its intuitive UI and powerful C# or Java as script building tools, you can now focus really in the main problem at hand and be more creative. Today we are going to cover some basic script building techniques in Unity by building scripts in C# to control our player. Now, as you know, we need to control our player, so we have to focus on our player itself. So first, what we will do is we will add a component and go to new script, and we will write this script as player movement. You create and add the script. Now you see we have a player movement script on the project window. To make it more arranged, what we'll do is we'll create new folder and name it scripts. We'll add that player movement script to this folder, and here you will see the basic layout of the script. Now double click on your script to open in C#. Once the script is open, you will see already some predefined code is present in the script. The start function is used to put the code which you need to use only once when your game is initialized, and it is only called at the starting of the frame. The update function is used to write that part of the code of your game which is needed to be used again and again, as it is called once per frame. I will show this to you with the Hello World example, the first program every program makes in the starting of the journey. So we'll write debug.log hello world. Don't forget to end it with a semicolon. Save. Now go back to Unity. Press play. Now you see that nothing is happening, but in the console here hello world is being written, as the start function only is called once when the frame is started. You can see it one time. Now if we write the same script, just take the script from here and write it and update. Save. Let's see now what will happen. Press play. See, it is being called again and again. So the console is outputting hello world again and again. So this is how these two functions work. Now we will move our player a bit. For this, you need to have physics in Unity. To put it in layman terms, you need to have friction between the two surfaces to make your object move. Now in Unity environment, that friction is calculated by the physics engine. To use the physics engine, you need to add the rigid body component to your object. Now to add our rigid body component, we need to select player we'll focus on it and add component physics, rigid body. Now you see there is a rigid body component in player. So now we can do physics calculation on our player. Now after adding the rigid body component, you need to have a public variable through which you can access this function. So we will create a public variable move. To do this, we will open up a script again. Remove this code. We will add public rigid body move. Now this language is case sensitive, to be sure to write the functions according to their case sensitive values, otherwise it will not work. Now once you save this, you will go back to Unity and you will see a component named moved is created. Now for this to work, you will have to add a reference point to rigid body. So you will take the rigid body and add it to move. Now you can access all the function rigid body through this move variable. We'll save it. So now let us try this move variable. To move the object, we need to add certain amount of force to the object. So we'll again open our script and we will add move dot add force. Now you see it has three vectors defined as x, y and z axis. So we will add a push as 0 for x axis, 100 for y and 200 for z axis. Don't forget to close it with a semicolon, otherwise it will not work. We will save it. Go to Unity and press play. See how the ball moves a certain distance. This is how this function is working. Now we have just applied a single force to our object as it was in the start function. So it is applied only once. Now what happens if we want to continuously move our object? For this, what we'll do is we'll again open our script and we will add, remove this function from here and say we add our object move dot add force 0, 0. We only wanted to move in the z axis, right? 100 semicolon save. Now let us see what happens. Now once we run the program, let's see what happened. You see the ball is thrown away. Now there is a bit of an error in this method because this function is being called once per frame and the force will wildly depend on your current frame rate, which can be different on the basis of many factors like computer speed or amount of processes running in the background. We'll slightly modify our code to move add force 0, 0, 100 star time dot delta time. For now, you just have to remember doing this will even out the frame rate difference when running the game in different scenarios. Also, you have to remember the update function used to call the code of the program which need the calculation again and again once every frame. But in Unity you have something called fix update, which is called only when the physics calculations are needed to be done. By using this, it will smooth out your physics operations and make your collisions or movement look more smooth. Now since moving the flare is a physics calculation, we will put our code in the fix update and let us see what happens. Remove all this code, the scenario, and write void fix update. Write move dot add force 0 for the x axis, 0 for the y axis, and 1000 into time dot the time. Let's see what happens. Play. Yeah. Now you cannot see much of a difference, but there's a lot of things playing around in this. And the best part is you will see the same speed in all type of refresh rates, makes it more smooth. That's all for today's episode. Play around with the script and see what you can do more. Also, don't forget to subscribe and click on the bell icon so you never miss a video again. Thank you for watching Straight Up Tech. Let's learn together. Have a great day.